Hey, replay viewers, check me out on YouTube, Penguin 6, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Penguin 6. Penguin 6 everywhere! And here in Hong Kong, exiting the zoo, on his way to get a second lunch. Well, I'm back. I think I figured out why the microphone was scratching on the last broadcast. I hadn't shaved. I didn't bring the molecular scanner. I had it last time we were there. Hey, California, welcome to Hong Kong. So I think the scratching noise you heard wasn't my microphone shorting out, but I think it was my beard. I've now shaved off my 5 days worth of beard. Yeah, we're going to fish and chips. That's our second lunch. We're here in Hong Kong. We just exited the Hong Kong Zoo and Botanical Gardens, where I had to go to the bathroom. It was actually a very, very clean public toilet. Though, when I was in Monaco this summer, the public toilet in Monaco, oh my god, it was amazing! Raspberry Pi YouTube, yeah, I was playing with that gadget the other day. I got a Raspberry Pi and a Scion, so I was playing with both of those in that unboxing. It is about lunchtime, it is 12:20. I've already ordered, I had to order because this Catholic school gets out in about 10 minutes. And all the kids make a beeline to the fish and chip shop. So I have got to get to Matthew's before the kids do. My kids get two breaks. They get Chinese New Year, which is a week off, and then they get Easter spring break. Good Friday and Easter Monday are public holidays. So they just go ahead and add four more days and call it spring break. You know, it's complicated. I just read a thing. See, if you work in Monaco, like as you're like a, I don't know, a waiter, well, you can just live across the border in the south of France and it's not as expensive. Whereas Monaco proper is obscene. Here in Hong Kong, there's no real option. Hong Kong is called China's Monaco. Washington, North Carolina. This is Hong Kong. We're next to the Cathedral of Immaculate Conception in central Hong Kong. We're making our way to a fish and chip restaurant. I didn't get a full portion today because I already had noodles. I had my first lunch earlier today, which was wonton noodles. And now we're making our way to our second lunch. Here, a flute. Yeah, well, I don't really eat breakfast that much, and I won't have a big dinner, so two lunches is perfectly fine. Tonight for dinner, I'll have a salad with some shredded chicken on it. But right now, we're going to lunch under the bamboo scaffolding. Hey, guess what? We're going to the peak. And you know what I brought with me? Hey, Chicago. I bought my drone. Yes, I have my man purse with me. My DJI Mavic. I brought it with me. Yes, it's a drone night. So we're going to take the drone up to the peak today. That'll be in about 45 minutes from now. Yeah, I never actually saw anyone that was waiting, but everybody tells me I sound like Ray Romano. No, that's my Mavic. I have my Mavic and I've got my DSLR today. I've been making my YouTube video blog series, Penguin 6 on YouTube. So we'll have a new video blog up later tonight. It won't be that interesting because I haven't really done much interesting today. Crime is basically non-existent. We have one of the lowest crime rates in the world. I mean, of course there is crime. Of course there are bad guys. There are murders even, but the numbers are just so ridiculously small. We don't worry about it. We had 28 murders last year. To put that in comparison, Chicago could have 8 murders a year. If Chicago had 8 murders a year, Chicago would have the same crime rate as Hong Kong. LA could have 12 murders a year. Baltimore could have 2. So if you could get down to those numbers, then you'd understand how the crime is in Hong Kong. The negative of that is that our children are being brought up in basically Bambi world. They have no concept of street smarts. They have no concept of, you know, wrong side of the tracks or anything like that. Hey, welcome to your first day of Periscope. Well, that's true. People have a lot of... The unemployment rate is rather low here compared to the U.S. And people are busy trying to make money. Chicago does have that crime. So here you see all the Filipino helpers waiting to pick up their wards. These are all nannies, nannies from the Philippines, waiting to pick up the children that they take care of from kindergarten. It's due to a lot of things, all right? It's easy to pick one thing, but it's not. We have more cops on the street. We have tougher sentencing laws. But we have stronger families. We have a sense of shame. We have a real emphasis on education. We have a good economy. And we have no guns. So, you know, a lot of people would like to pick and choose one thing or the other. The reality is we try everything and it kind of works. We have about 1,000 homeless people, but that's what the government says. Reality is probably 2,000, but we do have a lot of people living in substandard housing. We call cage homes or even shanties somewhere. I don't think it's possible to get higher than the U.S. rate of incarceration, to be honest. But when they do get arrested, there are pretty severe penalties. The other thing is that all these buildings, we live in these apartment buildings, and they're all guarded by private security, too. So, hey, here's a Tesla X. Yeah, there isn't a lot of violent crime on the street. Sexual assault numbers are much more reduced in the U.S. There are, like, there's still robberies, and there's drugs, of course, and there's pickpockets and stuff. Yeah, I lived in the U.S. most of my life when I moved here. Sorry, the camera's following my eye. There are Muslims here, a lot of Bangladeshis, Indonesians. There's over 100,000 Indonesians. There are mosques. There's a mosque, actually. There's a mosque right up there. But we don't really have a terrorism risk. Nobody's really pissed off in Hong Kong such that they want to blow up anyone. McDonald's delivery. Go, McDonald's man, go! I love some things about Hong Kong, the other things I don't. It's really expensive to live here. Good pollution, it gets hot. Hey, can I get... It's not better or worse, it's different. There are certain things about here that are nice that I enjoy. There are certain things I enjoy about the US, and I just make do with what I got. Here we go! Boy, mate!
Hey, bud.
Did you see the highlights? Low lights?
I didn't know it was playing, so I turned on the computer this morning. I forgot the game was on. I just read the report, so it sounds like it was a bizarre game. It's like we were 1-0 up, and during the first 45 minutes, we get the second half, should have been 2 goals up, had a penalty, could have been 3.
Easily. Giroud missed open net, header, had a penalty decline that should have been a penalty.
One against Walcott?
Yeah. I mean, he just fucking knocked out his legs. And then.
Did you watch the whole game?
Most of it. About second half.
Then we get a sending off, apparently, according to the reports, was an important sending off, was it?
Shoulder contact. Slight knee contact, and then Lewandowski just dies. 2 feet died.
Didn't he give him a yellow, then kept reversing
the yellow, and then the other drew, da-da-da-da-da, so he pulls out the red. Whatever. Sorry. Okay. Football. It was, and then it was, the floodgates were open. Yeah.
Ooh, what's this?
How many people play daily from China? Tons. But it's complicated. I mean, it's, you know, 45 minute transport time, and then 30 to 45 minutes. It can be as very long in the very long in immigration, depending on the lines. There are a lot of kids that commute for school. Yeah, we had the wonton noodles earlier. Now we're gonna have fish and chips at Hooked Fish and Chips. Matthew, just this, he's got this is for fish and chips, and then this is for fresh seafood. But he wants to open more branches, but he needs people to work for him. So if you want a job, go to Matthew's website. He'll hook you up. I'm serious. HookedHK on Facebook. It's delicious. It's New Zealand style fish and chips. And if you've never had New Zealand style, your life isn't any better. I mean, your life is not good.
10 minutes, we were pushing. We were trying for the next goal, and then we got overloaded. It was 2-on-1s, 2-on-1 breaks. I mean, literally, 2-on-1, 3-on-1, and they were tap-ins. There was a couple good shots, but basically...
So all the reports are not as dead as it sounds?
Yeah, I mean...
Yeah, sure, the result doesn't look fresh, but...
Better than the last 5-1.
You're trying to turn around a 5-1 distance away.
I mean, they played well the first half. Giroud was a little Giroud-y. I mean, the highlights are on YouTube. Just type Arsenal Bayern highlights on YouTube.
Yeah.
A little 5-minute clip you can watch. Gadgets today. It's my drone. Yeah, it's my Mavic, my DJI Mavic drone. I'm gonna go up to the peak and fly today. So. Kind of new. October of last year. So I'll take that up to the peak.
Yep.
And we'll do a broadcast up there.
What kind of cameras are they?
4K camera.
I mean,
yeah. It's pretty high res.
Yeah.
And I just do video, sometimes selfies.
Yeah.
But basically, it fits in your hand. Fold it up. It's about 10,000 Hong Kong, all in. With all the cool accoutrements and
yeah.
But
10,000 is that
even? Yeah. But it's pretty professional grade, you know?
Yeah. So what programs did you have for that?
You get an iPhone app.
That's it.
Yeah. You plug your iPhone in. Take a look. Yeah,
So when the case comes with it as well.
Yeah. Yeah.
Look at that. That's how small it is. Because I've had like the Phantom.
Yeah, those things are monstrous. Yeah.
And like, because
on one of my projects that I had, we actually had to do the bird's eye view of the whole project itself, and guy was just lugging it around, big display on his phone.
That's a monster. Oh, I'm a featured guy, so there's 200 people watching now.
Oh.
Crazy. So, hey guys, my second lunch. We're at Hooked Fish and Chips in Hong Kong. Eating New Zealand style fish and chips. And it's really good today. We're going to go up to the peak in about an hour, and we're going to fly the drone on the peak. So if you're following me, you can see that. I recommend it. Oh, wow. Travel feature. Okay. So this is Hooked Hong Kong. It's a fish and chip restaurant in Hong Kong. Style blue cod. Come visit Hong Kong if you can. It's a very thin batter, lots of fish. New Zealand style, not British style, New Zealand style. This was 100 Hong Kong, yes, which is about 12 US dollars.
I'm a dad, I do that.
Building a new website for live streamers who want to get sponsorship. Hear me better now? It's really low. I just put the mic in. Hopefully I'll cruise it. What do I do for a living? I'm a dad. I do dad stuff. Take care of my kids. So I have a nanny who takes care of the kids. So I do that too. I'm sort of like in management. I'm like middle management in the parenting duties, yeah. I'm rich. I have a wife who loves me and kids who love me. Dude, there's nothing more you need in life than that. We were rich well before we had money. We're not wealthy. Not by Hong Kong standards. But we get by. Three 360 cameras in my pocket. I'm not doing a 360 right now. I'm eating fish and chips, but to be honest, the fish is all gone. I'm not a billionaire by any stretch. I'm barely a millionaire by Hong Kong standards. You know, a guy tried to do a 360 on his drone, but it fell off. Chinese food, yeah? Why do the numbers go up and down? Well, people come in, people go away. Just depends. Okay. You guys want to go people watch?
No.
This is Hong Kong, yeah?
It's a very international city.
With tens of thousands of restaurants.
What type of job skills do you need? You need to be in banking, basically.
Basically, you need to be a professional. Well, I'll rephrase it. You don't need to be a professional, but it's a lot more fun if you're a professional.
So, I normally have one or two lunches every day. This is my second lunch.
Stupid microphone.
There we go. Is it hard to get a job? No. Is it hard to get a job that will afford you the lifestyle that you're used to in the United States over here? Probably. So let's go pay. I haven't paid Matthew yet. Got to get here before the kids. You watching the highlights?
No, I'm just reading about really the fucking practicing
post. Oh, people are nuts. Like Arsenal fan TV? Oh, they're just like going nuts.
Get rid of them a second. I've got to go now. Get rid of them a second. I can guarantee you get rid of a second. Next year, we'll do what Man United did for two or three seasons. We'll be a
number
eight. Top eight tie. You know?
Yeah, pretty miserable. It's gonna happen. It's miserable. So here we are, guys. We're at Hooked. Yeah. Cash only sign. Reporting. Why is that? This is pretty cool. Just one soda today.
What soda yet?
This is my second lunch.
What did you have for the first one?
Noodles.
That's why you're here.
What?
That's why you're here.
Well, I didn't have breakfast, so.
Huh?
I didn't have breakfast, yeah. So. I figured I could do two. So, cool, mate. Alrighty, catch you later. So you guys want to walk around Hong Kong a little bit? Take in the sights? Why would you report that sign? You can be cash only if you want. Death bus. Ooh, this one's coming really close. I do need water, but you know, the thing about fish and chips is it's really greasy, and water doesn't really clean your palate after you have fish and chips. You kind of like, that's why I don't drink Diet Coke that, I mean, I drink Diet Coke, yeah? But I drink it here more than anywhere else because it breaks through the grease. Unlike water. Did they get Periscope to change the title in the middle of the broadcast? Why? What was the title? Second lunch in Hong Kong before I hiked the peak. That was my title. That was a New Zealand style fish and chip shop. Kiwis. New Zealand style fish and chips are really good. They're kind of the same as Australian. Hey, little kid. Oh, change town. Nah, that's all right. You're Kiwi, eh? Kia ora, mate. We were just at a New Zealand-style fish and chip in China, which is kind of funny because all the fish and chips in New Zealand are owned by Chinese, so I'm told. And we were just featured. Now we're stuck in this stupid drone thing. There we go. There we go. Okay, what time is it? Lunchtime? 5 million views? I don't think so. Why, is there nothing else going on? 12:52 Hong Kong time. He's yelling on his cell phone. Does it get cold? Not really. I mean, it's cold today. It's like 56 degrees Fahrenheit on the peak. Yeah. When I do 360 scopes, I get 20,000. So this isn't bad. 7,000 views for a regular scope. It's not bad. Second lunch. No, that was my second lunch. I had noodles for first lunch. Fish and chips, second lunch. And then I think we're gonna go to the peak because I brought my drone. Yeah, I got my drone with me today. My rubbing against, you know, we had that problem earlier, and I think it's either my microphone sucks or there's a problem with Periscope's audio right now. We're not really sure what it is. Third lunch. No, not really. I'm going to have a light dinner tonight. I'm going to have a salad with chicken. That's my plan for dinner tonight. So here's Vera Wang. Rubbing noise stopped. I don't know what it is. Earlier we thought it was rubbing against my face because I didn't shave. So in Asia, this is the place you come to buy your wedding dress. So girls will fly in from Korea or Japan or Southeast Asia. They come to Hong Kong because there's a lot of very good, high-quality wedding dress places here. So they have like girls' party, like five or six women will fly out to buy a wedding dress. Let's make our way down into central Hong Kong where there's more people. I'm Penguin Six, by the way. You're in Hong Kong with me, as I am every day, showing the streets. Why are streets so narrow? Because land is so expensive. The streets were laid out by the British when the British were the colonial masters of Hong Kong. Cars were smaller. There weren't that many of them, so there was no real need for big, wide streets. Is it built on an ancient city? No, there used to be a fishing village here. No, that place has got a line. I always are interested to find places that have line. Everybody likes to get a selfie in front of this picture. Must be a hell. It's, well, everybody walks. I mean, there's only 550,000 cars. There's 7.3 million people and 550,000 cars, because most people just walk everywhere, yeah? That's why you don't see a lot of really overweight people here, because everybody is walking. They don't have semis delivering stuff. They have small trucks there. I don't think I've ever seen a big lorry, a big semi-tractor trailer in the city ever. But they do have these small Isuzus. It's more handicap accessible than China, mainland China, but not as much as the United States with the ADA. Americans. I am on Lyndhurst Terrace. I just came off Hollywood Road, and we are making our way down into central Hong Kong, where we're going to see so lots and lots of people. No little people watching, because I know you guys love to see all the people. Is it safe walking the city? This is one of the lowest crime areas in cities in the world. I'm featured, yeah. So we have an extremely low crime rate in Hong Kong. We had 28 murders last year. Now, put that in comparison, if Chicago could pull off eight murders a year in Chicago is the same as the murder rate in Hong Kong. This is a very international area where we're in. This is Soho. It's very mixed. Tourists and foreigners, bankers who work in this area. Most of the foreign bankers, our offices are around here. So seeing Guaylos, white folks, is very, very common here in Hong Kong, in this area.
Hey, California. Yeah, there are a lot of Teslas. There's over 5,000 Teslas in Hong Kong. 5,000. That's basically 1% of the automobiles are electric here in Hong Kong. Yeah, the Chicago had just a ridiculous... But I mean, if Hong Kong had something like 10 or 15 murders a day, it'd be like the same rate as Chicago or something mental like that. Jaywalking, no, it's complicated. Jaywalking is an American concept. In most countries in the world, pedestrians have right-of-way at all times. So if I was to step in front of this truck legally, he's supposed to stop. But so the U.S. to Hong Kong is 560 round trip, $560 round trip from most major destinations to the United States. Sometimes a little lower, usually much higher, like $700 round trip. But go to google.com/flights and type in a major airport like Newark or O'Hare or Dallas or something to Hong Kong, HKG, and ba-boom. You'll be shocked at the fares you can see the next month. You could probably find a fare under $600 easily. And it's about a 14-hour flight, 12 to 14 hours, depending on where you're coming from in the United States. So you guys could be here pretty easily. Currency, no, we have our own. We have a Hong Kong dollar. Would you get rumor? I assume you mean run over. Yeah, I'd probably get run over. So this is the costume markets. This is where everybody goes for their fancy dress costumes and Halloween costumes. They do smoke here cigarettes, yes. Not as much as in China, though. China has a real problem with cigarettes. Like 1950s America problem. These are all the wigs you can buy. These are all the masks. You look at the scary one at the top right next to the unicorn. Yoda, Beast, Trump. Ooh, look at that. It's like angry, grouchy Smurf mask. $1 is 7.75 Hong Kong dollars. It's a fixed exchange rate. It never changes. So something that says 78 Hong Kong dollars is 10 US. Trump, he's back over there. But Hillary is down here. Yeah, Hillary's right over there. Hillary's here next to... I have no idea who that is. I know that's supposed to be Hitler. Hong Kong is part of China, but culturally, politically, it's very different. We have our own laws. We have our own government that's appointed by China. We have our own independent judiciary. English is the official language of Hong Kong, as is China. I do live here. And so it's very different. We have our own immigration policies. We do have Chinese military troops stationed in here. The Chinese flag flies over the city. The Chinese national anthem is played before our soccer games, and the fans boo. We've actually been fined by FIFA. FIFA fined Hong Kong for booing the national anthem, their own national anthem. Not for booing the other country's national anthem. Yeah, there are a lot of Muslims. Are there crazy laws? Not really. Why is it a fixed dollar so others can fluctuate? Because Hong Kong needs a stable currency. They don't need a currency that pegs up and back and forth. Most of the financial transactions here in Hong Kong are between the United States and China, so having a fixed currency rate here just kind of makes sense. You worked in Hong Kong as a nanny? Oh, wow, that's rough. What's the weather day? Today it's about 58 Fahrenheit. That's about 17 Celsius, 18 Celsius. How's work life here? Well, it depends what you do, yeah? I mean, there's a lot of banking, very high-stress bankers. There's a lot of marketing, a lot of fashion. It's stable. So let's go into Central Hong Kong. Let's play Spot Your Future Wife. Spot Your Future Wife. Hong Kong is to China like Puerto Rico is to the United States, though slightly different. 11,000, yeah, that's pretty good. So we have a problem here. We have too many single women and not enough single men. Mathematically, for every 1,000 women between age 20 and 30, there's only about 860 men. Because many of those men would prefer to date mainland Chinese girls because they think that they're less demanding than Hong Kong's. So, can't get a text back. Dude, you got to come here where there's just literally not enough men. It does look like New York. I don't have a second mic. I should probably get one. You guys are all complaining. This one sucks. Yeah, it's ranked the number one dating site in the world, number one city in the world to be a single man. Conversely, it's ranked as one of the worst places in the world to be a single woman. Go to the Apple Store.
There's bird flu in China. Occasionally we get a bird here that has bird flu, but not that often. I don't think we've had any local cases of human transmission, though there have been some people who got bird flu somewhere else and came back to Hong Kong. The government says there's 1,000 homeless people. The private sector scoffs at that, says it's probably 2,000. That's in a city of 7.3 million people. Hong Kong women are very demanding. They don't tolerate bullshit. Oops, sorry. There are a lot of people living in substandard housing, however. About 50% of the people live in public housing, public or subsidized housing. The rest of us pay through the nose. It's very expensive to live as a Westerner. The average family in my son's international school spends $11,500 US dollars, $11,500 American dollars per month in rent. Yeah, I did. Public housing like the project. Well, they are technically housing estates, but they're not crime-infested, drug-infested projects like you see in the United States or Europe. My son's best friend, his family is paying $31,000 US dollars a month in rent, 31 grand American per month in rent. That's a bit mental, I think. 11,000 US, yes, yes. We're renegotiating our lease. Our landlord currently wants to raise it to 8,200 US dollars a month, 8,200 per month. So a gallon of milk runs you about 14 US dollars. A box of Cheerios is about 10 US dollars. But you can hire a nanny, a full-time live-in domestic helper for 600 US dollars a month. So, you know, that's kind of nice. It's very common in the financial world to make, well, a lot of money. Most of the expats in the financial industry are making about $200,000 US a year, and then they're also given a housing allowance that pays their rent or pays for private schools and stuff. Average income, Hong Kong citizen average income is 2,000 US dollars a month. If they have a college degree, it's about 3,000. Yeah, you had 250. Yeah, nannies, domestic helpers make about 600 US right now. That's up to about 500 or 600 US now per month, plus housing. I get cereal from the Western grocery store. Actually, to be honest, I buy it in the US and bring it back. It's just cheaper. There are Mexican foods suck. They suck. Mexican places taste like Baja Fresh. There's actually a movie theater being built right over here, and there's a bunch more down to my left. To live like a Westerner, yes, but I mean Jonathan J.K., another Periscoper from Hong Kong who teaches English, he lives in a place that cost him 1,000 U.S. dollars a month, and he gets by as a teacher teaching English. English tutors can make like $40 or $50 an hour U.S. Where is this? This is in central Hong Kong. You are at the intersection of Queens Road Central and Pedder Street, P-E-D-D-R. Well, that's the BMW electric car. Okay, guys, you ready to go out in the middle of this stuff? As they say in rugby, engage! Yes, we do have double-deckers. We have double-decker buses and double-decker trams. And that taxi really shouldn't be there. Shiny, happy people, holding shiny, happy people. They're not happy because this taxi's squeezing them into a choke point. And then they'll get picked off by snipers. Why did I stay in the middle of the road? Because it was cool. Yeah? Wasn't it fun? Yeah, that taxi ran the red light, basically. Yes, I do know Chinese swear words. I hear them yelled at me all the time. That's what happens when you marry a Chinese wife. In fact, I think that was some of the first words I learned. Were Chinese obscenities. It does look a bit like New York. In fact, we have a lot of New Yorkers living here. We have New York-style pizza here. We don't have any Chicago-style pizza, which is our loss. No, they don't yell at you for being a white guy, not at all. They yell at you for annoying them. There is Uber, but nobody uses it. Why would you use Uber when you can get a cab? Cab's half the price of Uber, and you don't have to wait 5 minutes. You just raise your hand and you get one. There's cabs everywhere. People out in the new territories farther out, they'll use Uber a little bit more, but down here where I am in central Hong Kong, I don't have time for Uber. It's too slow. Are there a lot of Brits here? No, there are more Americans than there are Brits. The average work week, I have no idea. The Chinese do have a high savings rate because they just don't spend a lot on stuff they don't need. The gross domestic product of Hong Kong is comparable to that of Germany. So we have a higher GDP per capita than Germany. Just to give you an idea, there's a double-decker tram. I do drive when I take my kids to soccer practice, but usually I just walk. It's not that hectic, honestly. I'm in the center of Hong Kong at the middle of rush hour. I'm going up to the peak, however, and I'll probably be the only person up there. I'll be all by myself. So that's Louis Vuitton, Tiffany's, Armani. Who else is down there? Yves Saint Laurent, Chanel, Prada. There are no bicycles here, yeah. Not in this area. You get run over. There are not enough women in China overall. There is racism predominantly against darker skinned people like Southeast Asians, Filipinos, Indonesians, and against Africans more so than against, say, me, a Caucasian. I kind of get a pass. I mean, I guess people say bad things about me, but I don't really care, honestly. They don't really have any power. We have typhoons that come through. They're hurricanes, basically, but they come and go really quick. Who's buying all the Chanel, Vera Wang? Mainland Chinese tourists come to Hong Kong. You have no idea how much money there is in China right now. I mean, the disposable wealth amongst the upper classes in China is insane. I mean, they literally have millions and millions of U.S. dollars. They come down here and they buy legit stuff. They don't want to buy the fakes. Well, that's kind of a cool door thing. That way nobody will bang into his door when he opens it. Yeah, cool. Yeah, you can actually, these skywalks go for miles, basically. I mean, I can walk all the way over the next neighborhood of Admiralty without ever going, touching foot on ground. Chinese Hong Kongers are more like Southern Chinese in the sense that they generally are a little bit shorter and thinner than their mainland compatriots. Mainlanders are getting very heavy, and Northern Chinese are a bit taller than, say, Southern Chinese. No, Chinese do buy fakes all the time, but the ones who can afford not to prefer to come down here and get the legit stuff. No, it's a total gun ban. No guns allowed here in Hong Kong. Nobody has a gun. I mean, some bad guys might, but we have total gun control. There are a few people of color, but not a lot. The city is ethnically about 95% Chinese. That is about 2%. 2 or 3% Southeast Asian. It's 0.7% Caucasian. That's about 70,000 Caucasians. And most of the Caucasians are Europeans, British or French or Australian. There are Americans, of course. Most of the Americans, however, there are more Americans, though, but most of them are Chinese Americans. So they don't really notice them. There are beggars, of course. But they usually get run off by the police pretty quickly. There are some Spanish people, not a lot. There are not a lot of Hispanics. There are there's a fair smattering of Africans. I wouldn't say there's that many African Americans. There are more African Africans than there are African Americans. McDonald's, they're everywhere. There's one just up ahead here. There's over 200 McDonald's in Hong Kong, including the world's first McDonald's next. If you go to my YouTube channel, Penguin 6 on YouTube, you can see the McDonald's Gourmet restaurant, which is a gourmet waitress service McDonald's we have here in Hong Kong. I love to eat there. That's on my YouTube channel, Penguin 6. You guys should check that out as well. I do a video blog over there. The police are not as corrupt as they used to be. We have an independent corruption police called the ICAC, which can arrest police officers. So actually, Hong Kong is considered a model in anti-corruption circles, a model to be replicated in many other parts of the world. We are in central Hong Kong on Connaught Road, across from the Hong Kong Stock Exchange.
and the IFC 2 tower, the building that Batman jumped off of in The Dark Knight Begins. We do have Burger King, not a lot, a few, but they serve beer. Burger King serves beer. We have been to, I go to Happy Valley. I have not been to Sha Tin in a long time. Horse racing is a huge business here. The horse racing tracks here make more money in one night than American tracks make in an entire year. I can bet on horses, yeah. I can bet on sports, too. My wife is in India this week on a business trip, so I'm all by myself. We don't have casinos here, but right over there is the Macau ferry terminal, where we can catch a high-speed ferry over to Macau, which is the land of casinos. The drinking age in the bars is 18. However, to purchase alcohol in a retail establishment, there is no age limit. My 10-year-old son can buy beer at 7-Eleven. Horse racing tracks make an unbelievable amount of money here in Hong Kong. Unbelievable amount. Just millions and millions of dollars per night. I walk 10 miles every day. I have to walk about another 5 minutes to get to the ferry terminal. Yeah, that's why in my son's international school, it's known as Club 7-Eleven. Hey, let's go to Club 7-Eleven. Yeah. Parker's 8. I don't know if Parker can buy beer. We should try that one night. Toll escalators. No, the escalators are free. In fact, they give you a discount on the subway. If you ride the escalator, they give you a $2 discount, which is like 50 cent discount. Hey, I'm featured still. Yeah. 10 miles a day. Yeah, that's why I lost 60 pounds. Diet, exercise. How far is Macau? It's a 45-minute by high-speed jet ferry. I'm going to take you over and we'll go look at the jet ferries because they're cool. He lives in North Korea. He cannot come to Hong Kong. There are people smoking, but not a lot. Not like mainland China. So I'm Penguin6. You can also watch me on YouTube, Penguin6, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, all that. A lot of people are fit because, well, we walk everywhere, yeah? I mean, most people walk to work. They ride public transit and they walk. And as a result, it's a mixed bag. People here walk everywhere. You want to go buy groceries, you walk. You want to go to dinner, you walk. You want to go to the hardware store, the doctor, you walk. As a result of that, there are a lot more people out on the street. As a result of that, the streets are a bit more safer. Because the streets are safer, more people feel comfortable walking. I think the statistics say something like 85% of the people feel comfortable walking at any time, day or night, in their neighborhood. That contrasts to the United States, where it's about 42%. Safer streets, more people. Now, the problem in the U.S. is that we have bigger houses in the U.S. We have bigger yards, so we're more spread out. So the walking distance is farther. So you need a car. So then the need for sidewalks is diminished. And then if there's no sidewalks, no one walks. It's just a big catch-22. It's one of the things I don't like about the U.S. When you live somewhere where everybody walks, women wear boots. Boom, boom, boom. These boots are made for walking. That's just what they'll do one of these days. The air quality day is not bad, but other days it can be pretty disgusting. In the winter, in the summer, it's pretty good. But in the winter, the air comes down from mainland China. You hate Tokyo. Well, this isn't Tokyo, this is Hong Kong. I like Tokyo. Good noodles. So we're on our way over to the Macau ferry terminal. I've had two lunches today. I've lived here 7 years with a wife and two kids. I have no idea what a massage costs. Though there are websites that tell you the costs of everything you can get serviced in Hong Kong. Everything. What do I do here? I'm a dad. I do dad stuff. Like today, I'll be taking my kids to soccer practice. I'm making a video blog today. There are a lot of women here because there are just too many women and not enough men. The ferry to Macau is about $30 round trip. It is not easy to get lost because there's not that many roads.
Once you know the five or six major east-west arteries, you just walk around and you'll run into one of those roads eventually. I met my wife in law school in the United States. Fell in love, got married, moved to Hong Kong with her. What causes the smog? Big factories. Your iPhone caused the smog. The factory that builds your iPhone is just across the border. It's powered by coal-powered power plants that belch smoke into the air, and then it blows down from China over our city. So basically, every gadget you have puts smog in the air over my city. Thanks, everyone. Apple, Samsung, all the companies of Shenzhen. Shenzhen was a small town just across the border of Hong Kong, about 200,000 people 20, 30 years ago. It's now 15 million people. 15 million. I don't practice here. Is it easy for a poor American man to marry a rich Chinese wife? I guess. It depends on you. I mean, it depends what you have to offer. Are you educated? Are you nice? Do you treat her well? I don't really worry about money. Do you have potential? Or are you just a slouch? I mean, if you're just going to come over here and be one of those backpacking American tourists who just lives out of youth hostels, I mean, you can do that. I mean, some women like American men, but most women here like successful people. Doesn't matter what your nationality is. Are you respectful and a gentleman? Sometimes. Try to be. Gotta have a code, to quote Omar. Man, gotta have a code. Actually, it's pretty mellow now. What am I doing here? I'm walking to the Macau ferry terminal where I will grab a taxi. And what time is it? 1:18. What is this peak that we're going to? The peak is the highest mountain in Hong Kong Island. It is the one that offers the postcard views of the city. So we will head up to the peak in a bit and look down upon the skyscrapers from up there. I like the wire, yeah. I have a house in Maryland, so I can relate to Baltimore. I'm an Asian guy in America. What suggestions do you give then? Be a nice guy, break the mold. I will say one thing, a lot of American women have sort of a thing about not dating Asian guys. It's not as common here. If you come to Hong Kong, I mean, there are like the Caucasian women who grow up here, who were born here and grown up here. I know many of them who dated are married to Asian men. It's just not a big thing. In the United States, however, I'm still kind of a whatever about it. There's still sort of some stereotypes that makes it difficult for Asian guys to date Caucasian men, women. Interesting though, those women who come to Hong Kong who are like, I don't want to date an Asian guy. They come here and they quickly discover they're going to have a very empty social calendar. I'm from Calvert County. My house. So I work in D.C. But, oh, one of the big ferries is coming back from Macau. We can see it dock. Fortunately, though, it's not going at full speed. Still, it's pretty cool. Ferry rides about 45 minutes on these high-speed catamarans. If you're in a hurry, though, you could take the choppa. The choppa is on top. I am old. My half plus seven rule is 32, which means I can date Scarlett Johansson, but Emma Watson is too young for me. Half plus seven is 32. Do they have slots on the ferry? No, most people just try to avoid throwing up because it can be a little bouncy sometimes. The tallest building is right over there, the ICC Tower. You can take a chopper every 15 or 20 minutes. There's a chopper service to Macau. I don't have my passport with me. I would need my passport to go to Macau. Here comes a ferry in from Macau. This is one of the high-speed trimarans. No, I'm not on vacation. That's where I live. Though my life is kind of like a vacation, I guess. I'm not going to see Beauty and the Beast. I just looked at the Vanity Fair pictures. Here we go. This is a high-speed ferry coming back from Macau. Aren't these badass? Sorry. No, they don't roll dice on the boats. The boats are pretty fast. The chopper is like 200 US. The ferry is like 40 bucks round trip. Macau is like Vegas on steroids. I come back to the US every now and then, probably once a year. I'm a dad. Yeah, I know a lot of people are upset that Beauty and the Beast has a gay character. It interferes with their story of a woman falling in love with a bear. passport. Macau has its own immigration system that is separate than China and Hong Kong. Immigration hard? No, it's pretty easy to come here. So there goes a ferry off to mainland China. That one is probably headed up to Zhuhai. Yeah, they got to get these boats in and then out again. They're like no time, no rest for the wicked. They do have, they can really turn them out. In fact, I think the next one's coming out. Woo, cool. Battery just backed up to let that guy come in. I think he's coming out. Yeah, so we're going to get to see one come by in its full badass glory. Maybe. Yeah, so, oh, you can look underneath it, yeah? Check it out. You can see the three hulls, yeah? Isn't that cool? Sorry. I ride on this all the time when I go to Macau. Let me zoom out. Sorry about this. There we go. Oh, it's not even, it can't even go full speed until it gets out of the harbor. So in about 4 or 5 minutes, it'll really kick up. It goes about 45 knots or 52 miles an hour, something like that, on its way over to Hong Kong, to Macau. They do serve snacks. Most people just throw them up, though. Actually, it's pretty smooth. My wife gets easily boat sick. I don't. Look at the... Yes, that's where the half-brother used to live in Macau. He'll be there in about 45 minutes. The interior, there's two. You can sit first class. First class sits upstairs, and coach sits downstairs. First class has these nice leather seats, and they serve meals with a tray. Downstairs, you buy Coke and potato chips. My kids are 8 and 10. So this is actually an international border, basically. So there's a full-on immigration station in here. You scan your passports and everything when you come across. This is a hydrofoil over here. This is a Boeing hydrofoil. This one will actually get up on its skids when it flies over this to Macau. Alrighty, let's go inside. So upstairs here, you can actually buy escorts for your trip to Macau. You can pre-arrange your escorts. And they have pictures, too. You guys don't believe me, do you? You really want me to show you. Escorts, hookers. Prostitution is legal in Hong Kong and Macau, so... I make YouTube videos. I have a new company I'm starting right now. I did most of the work this morning. They're very open about it. They even have a website. So you can review them on, there's like websites that review them. Yep, KFC, Starbucks, McDonald's. It doesn't snow. I didn't go to Apple. No, pimping is illegal. Running a brothel, being a pimp, making a living off another person who's doing prostitution is illegal. But if you're a woman working, or man, working in the pleasure, in a company of your own home, you can do what you want. They don't care. So if you work in your own house, you know, like a single room occupancy brothel is legal. So there's like one apartment building that's filled with nothing but basically working gals, called the Fuji Hotel. Okay, so we're going to go past this travel agent and look on the window. Look back inside. Can you see it? There you go. So that's the different escort services. Some of them are more blatant. They just show them right out here, yeah? They do have a public health department. Yeah, so basically window shopping, which spa, Double Dragon spa and massage. Oh, that one actually dresses like a policewoman. Far out. Male escort. Where am I going? I'm going over this way. Oh yeah, it's still pretty scary. This place is nothing but spas. I'm starting I have an influencer marketing website to put live streamers in touch with brands who want to advertise with live streamers. I don't know what the costs are. There are websites that tell you the current rates. Though up in like Macau or in Hong Kong, they actually advertise on the side of the street. So this is coming soon. Bullet Train Sushi. Sushi delivered by Bullet Train, opening in April. I'm still being featured. That's amazing. Must be a pretty boring Periscope day if I'm still featured. So this is Konkatsu. I don't think they have to register. John Ho and, they're taking all my streams. Maybe I should sign off. You guys can watch John Ho and Jonathan JK. They're two other scopers from Hong Kong. What is the name of the money? We have Hong Kong dollars, HKD, a Hong Kong dollar. How's my battery doing? 42% battery life. Gotta save some of the battery for the cake. Cake. You know, I do need to get to the peak. What time is it? Crap, it's 1:30. I need to boogie on up to the cake. I'm sorry, boogie on up to the peak. There's McDonald's. Okay, Vegas. We're in the Macau Ferry Terminal. It's not really a mall. It's just where people go to Macau. Good cake here. Yeah, it is, but it's not as much sugar as the U.S. U.S. cake has more sugar. I am on the wrong level for a taxi. I need to go down one more level to get a taxi. I do have a battery charger, but right now this is my iPhone 7, and I've got my my headset is plugged into it, so... Tiramisu, I'm sure we can find that. So we're gonna go get a Starbucks all over the place. ETA to the peak. Well, we're gonna jump in a cab and we'll be there in about 10 minutes. Cab is gonna cost me about $8 or $9 US. Oh, there's a little bit of a line, but they don't know how to do it. They're supposed to move forward. Well, they do. So we gotta wait in the taxi line. Three stalls. Air song. Didn't get it now. We do have Uber, but we don't use it because cabs are cheaper and faster. Three taxi positions. 1, 2, 3. Right there, yeah. So hard to figure out the concept that three cabs at the same time. I don't know. Hey, Li Hao. Sanden Gongshen. Yeah, they do speak English. No, I'm not doing 360. Just doing a regular one today. We're on our way to the peak. You guys are going to get a beautiful view of the city. I don't speak much, just a few directions. No, it doesn't smell bad. No, I just cut. I was in line. I just didn't want to wait for them to come all the way up. That's faster than what I did. The peak? Oh, it's not that hard. You were in a parking garage at the moment in Hong Kong. We're going to make our way up to the peak, where I'll show you the view, and then I'm going to go for a walk. I don't speak Chinese. I speak English. A few words.
I want a hamburger with a Diet Coke. I know how to say that. Wu yao han ba bao. Wu yao ling du ke le. With bing kuai, ice cubes. But that's about it. I'm in a cab. I'm just trying to be polite. Don't want to be like blah, 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 blah.
I had noodles
and then I had fish and chips. So I've had two lunches today. Now we're up to the peak. No, there's not much crime. I mean, there's some, but not really. Yeah, that's pretty good. Usually we do the other one, we have more. We're up to about 21,000 people. That's pretty good. Yeah, they speak English. Everything's in English. Of course, the game starts here at 3:45 in the morning. Yeah, they were shooting missiles towards Japan. Well, that's the other direction, not towards us. Mr. Taxi, Taxi, Taxi. I always think of that Girls' Generation song, Taxi. Mr. Taxi, whenever I'm in a taxi.
You guys don't know Girls' Generation?
Do you wish I was born Chinese?
No, I don't really care what I was born. I'm not my ethnicity, I'm not my passport, I'm me. So, I don't really...
We are a day ahead of you, it is Wednesday. It is Wednesday about 1:30 in the afternoon.
I like Hong Kong. I like things about Hong Kong. There are things I don't like, too. Everything is different. Hey, Oomph is here. She's from Hawaii. I'm Irish-German. Yeah, I mean, here in Hong Kong, two passports is very common. Yeah. I'm the walrus. I don't like spinach. I don't like wet socks. I don't like the price, how expensive it is. I don't like the air quality sometimes. I don't like the housing. I don't like when it's cold, because when it's cold, your house is cold. I like walking. I like the food. Yeah, we'll be at the peak in about 10 minutes. Less than that. We're on our way up now. So this next building is the People's Liberation Army here. So this is a Chinese military base right here. There's Chinese soldiers in there. In fact, armed troops. Yeah, we'll move back one day, probably, maybe. Unless we move to Europe. The peak is the tallest mountain in Hong Kong. It's about 1,800 feet above sea level. And we're heading up to it. It's also where all the rich people live. And I go for a hike there every day. So we're going up to the peak for my hike. This is the military base. Yeah, that's that's the headquarters of the Chinese military in Hong Kong. And then there's some barracks over here where the soldiers are garrisoned. Probably it's going to take about 5-10 minutes. 7 minutes from here. I don't know where we'd go. Everybody lives in a flat. Nobody really has a house here. And apartments. They're very standalone houses here. Where should I go? I like Paris. I like Germany. I like Amsterdam. I like London. No, no real effect on people here. I'm bemused, like everybody else in the world. Confused, too. It is a concrete jungle, but 75% of Hong Kong is actual jungle, and that's where we're heading. We're heading up to that mountain up there, the peak. 1997, a flat is an apartment building. I live up here on these mid-levels. I actually live right over here in this building. Mostly a lot of dogs. In fact, if you look at my YouTube channel, Penguin 6, you can see all the dogs we saw yesterday. We saw lots of dogs yesterday. No earthquakes. We're outside of the Ring of Fire. I'm going to the peak, the tallest mountain in Hong Kong. I'm going to show you the entire skyline of the city. My rent is just being raised. The landlord raised the rent. So it'll be about $8,200 US a month. $8,200 US a month. There's only 500,000 cars. No, they don't eat dogs. It's against the law. It's been against the law for 50 years. The law here is actually stricter than the U.S. 44 U.S. states actually allow you to eat dogs and cats for personal consumption, but here in Hong Kong, any eating of dog or cat is illegal and has been for over 50 years. But the United States, 44 states, haven't quite caught up with the Hong Kong. I don't really practice that much. Yuling, there's an area of China where they do eat dogs. There are many areas where it's outlawed. Hong Kong vacation, go to Europe and other... Well, short vacations, we go to Asian areas, and long vacations, we'll go to Europe or the U.S. Yeah, there is a dog festival, Yuling, Y-U-L-I-N. But that's going to be shut down soon, I think. Believe it or not, most people in China find the practice repulsive. They don't like it, and they feel it. Well, usually we walk. We don't drive many places. Well, if you type dogs in USA, you'll find a petition to stop the practice in the United States. Because believe it or not, it's not outlawed in most states. But if you type dog meat USA, you will find a petition from animal welfare organizations trying to get it shut down in the United States. We do drive British style. We're driving on the left. People are people. There'll be good people and bad people pretty much everywhere you live. There are people here who treat their pets nicer than you do, and there are people here who treat them worse. People are people. It doesn't really matter what. I have heard of factory farms. Several of those. Puppy mills in the United States and stuff. I grew up as a farm boy. You drive on the left, the driver sits on the right. That's the hard thing to remember when I go back to the U.S. is I have to switch over and drive on the right hand side. The easy way to remember is that when you're the driver of the car, you are always near the center line. So if you're driving in the U.S. or you're driving over here, you have to stay near the middle, the dividing line. I do live in the mid-levels, midway up the peak. The Chinese drive the same way. And it's so high. Average income is, well, it depends what you do. That's similar to New York or London, but most of us are given a cost of living package that helps with the rent and the public schools. My son spends, his school is about 25,000 US a year per kid. No, they clean up. I mean, minimum wage is only $4 US, so it's pretty easy to hire people to clean the streets. There are lots of bus tours here. because they drive like crap. We're still going higher. Going up the mountain. I think Kroenke should leave Arsenal. My home shows all around. I can see a lot of Hong Kong, but not everything. Darbu is here, yeah. About 15% Christian, probably 40 or 50% Buddhist, and the rest are sort of indifferent. Yes, there are Muslims. Indonesians, Pakistanis, Bangladeshis, some Arabs. There are several Muslims. Tigers in about 70 years. The last tiger here was killed about 60, 70 years ago. There are rumors of big cats up in the new territories, but I've never seen them. Oh god, my wife's awake. Why killed? Because it ate a policeman. It bit a policeman and killed him, so they shot it. So we're almost to the peak, guys. I'm Penguin 6. I hike you around Hong Kong every day. So feel free. We're going to show you the skyline of the city in just a bit when we get up to the top. It does look that way, doesn't it? So here's some Hong Kong money. This is a $20 bill. This is about $3 US, or $2.5 US. I don't really know what the national anthem is. This is 100 Hong Kong. This is about this is about $12 US. This is printed by HSBC. Oh, this is Bank of China. This is a Bank of China note, and then this one is also Bank of China. There's different ones. The fare right now is $50, so about $6 US. So far, if you've been with me from the beginning, it's $6 US. National anthem. Animal. I don't really think we have. We have wild boar here. Top part of the San Francisco is hilly. Hong Kong is mountainy. No, the pandas aren't really native to this part of Hong Kong. Pandas are more of a northern China, more of the snow. It's too hot here for pandas. Wild pandas. There are landslides, but they do a lot of landslide control. It's not like Bangladesh where landslides kill like 100 people. Every now and then there's a rock that rolls down into an apartment. In this area is the bald eagle. We don't have bald eagles here. There are lots of eagles where I live in Maryland, on the Chesapeake Bay. There are monkeys, but I don't think the monkeys are indigenous to Hong Kong. I think they're an introduced species. When did I move here? About 2010? So I've been here about 7 years.
Come to my tampon and
year 7 of a 3-year assignment. We don't have a ball. We don't have a national anthem over there. No, we're not a nation, we're just a city.
You're under a bridge in Hong Kong as we make our way to the peak.
I do dad stuff, take care of my kids. We're going to go walk around the peak here in a bit. I was thinking about flying a drone. No, there's no earthquakes here. We don't get earthquakes. I don't know China. Maybe at the end of it's part of China. I don't know if they have a national anthem. The crane, the stork, pretty popular. There is a monkeys in, not ours. There's a place called Monkey Hill where all the monkeys are. It's like 3,000 monkeys up there, 4,000 monkeys up there. I don't really work. I do make iPhone videos. I make videos for my YouTube channel, Penguin 6, and I'm starting a new company. But most of the stuff I do is dad stuff, take care of my kids and stuff. My kids are. My kids do speak Mandarin and English. Well, English is the predominant language at their school, but they speak Chinese every day. They choose Hong Kong. Hong Kong is a really nice place to live, actually. That's where my wife's job is. So. Maybe we'll choose another place where we're going. No, the people here speak Cantonese. What you're listening to on the radio is Cantonese, but my children speak Mandarin, which is the other language. Would I choose to live here? I actually like it here, believe it or not. It's a nice place to raise your kids. It's safe. It's very cosmopolitan and international. There's a good community here. It's easy to live here. Not as hectic as the United States, where I have to drive everywhere. We're almost there, guys. That's the peak right up there, those buildings right there. We're almost there. No, they can't converse, but they can write to each other because they have the same character set, basically. But they don't really, talking is more difficult. You can learn, though. It's a different pronunciation. Imagine speaking English and pronouncing all the vowels differently. So, yeah. And there are some different words. Almost there, guys. Almost there. You can tell the difference. More la's and ah's and different things. Oh, cool. That's gonna be 20. Oh, thank you. Bye bye. Oh. And we're here. Woo! The city is ethnically Chinese, about 95% ethnically Chinese. It's about 0.7% Caucasian, about 3% Southeast Asian. Another miscellaneous. So let's just get out of this thing. No, there's 28 murders last year, most of them by meat cleaver or throwing out of a building or something. This taxi, I actually tipped him about $1 US, so I paid about $10 US. It was about $8 or $9, so I tipped him $1. It was a little bit slow through Central, so we had to pay a little bit more. Yeah, the choppa. They call it chopper. So when somebody gets attacked by a meat cleaver, they say, oh, it was attacked by a choppa. Get to the choppa. So this mall's being renovated, so all the stores are actually closed right now. Oh, wow. They really, like, everything's getting closed. Unreal. There are walkable parts of some cities in the U.S., but the thing is, it's different. A walkable part, someplace that's described as walkable in the U.S. has some restaurants and some bars, but it doesn't have a grocery store or it doesn't have a hardware store. Here, everything's walkable. Hardware store, grocery store, car parts, doctor, lawyer, Indian chief. I mean, it's all walkable. How many malls they got there, nobody knows, honestly. We don't even know how many restaurants there are in Hong Kong. The number is somewhere between like 35,000 and 50,000 restaurants. Nobody's really sure. I'm serious. They do not know how many restaurants are in Hong Kong. They know how many licensed restaurants there are, but they're not really sure how many places there are that are serving food. You could eat Western food every day of the year at a different restaurant and never repeat yourself. I mean,
Why do people choose Hong Kong to invest in? Because it has Western-style laws. Our laws are British law, basically. We follow basically common law, like England, Australia, Canada. It has hundreds of years of history, and it's very predictable. China follows well. Who really knows, you know? The law in China isn't as solid. So people who want to put money into China do so through Hong Kong because they know they have the legal protection of centuries of legal precedents and an independent judiciary. So guys, guess what? We're almost here, almost to the view of the skyline that I promised you. Boy, it's a bit windy. I'm sorry. You guys wanted the view, yeah? There you go. Yeah, of course people actually have a higher, more kids committed suicide last year than there were murders. The pressure, academic pressure on the children is very high here. Very, too high actually. Debuchi Wubuzadal, I don't read Chinese characters. Is it safe to fly the drone? Safe enough. It's a little windy back there. I have to go somewhere a bit mellower. Second lunch, I ate two lunches a day. Why? Because I can. You guys ready for the view? Excuse me. There you go. See Lord of the Rings, yes. There's the city. You can see my house. I live here. This is the Bank of China. And the black one is Citibank. HSBC and Standard and Chartered there. That's the IFC 2 tower. But it's not as tall as the ICC. This is number one, and this is number two. This is Victoria Harbor.